kepada Ibu Dr. Feni Purwani, M.Kom, untuk menyampaikan. Kami persilakan, Bu.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Pertama-tama izinkan saya menyampaikan salam terhormat kepada Bapak Dekan Fakultas Sains dan Teknologi UIN Raden Fatah Palembang, Bapak Dr. Munir MAG. Alhamdulillah tadi beliau sudah memberi kesempatan untuk memberi wawasan kepada keintegrasian keilmuan dengan teknologi dan budaya Melayu. Yang terhormat hadir juga di ruangan kita ini Wakil Dekan 1 Bapak Dr. Ilham Falahuddin MSI, Bapak Dekan 2 Ibu Dekan 2 Dr. Delima Engga Mareta MKes, Wakil Dekan 3 Bapak Muhammad Isnaini MAG MPD. Ya, tentu juga yang sangat kami banggakan, selamat datang Ibu jauh dari Malaysia tapi tetap dekat di hati, Ibu Associate Profesor Dr. Nur Asikin Ali dari Universiti Tenaga Nasional Selangor Malaysia. Selamat datang, Prof. Bapak Ibu Prodi Sains dan Teknologi, Ibu Bapak dosen beserta para peserta kuliah tamu yang alhamdulillah diberi kesempatan untuk segenap sivitas Fakultas Sains dan Teknologi. Bapak Ibu, adik anak kami juga mahasiswa alhamdulillah di sini hadir. Pertama-tama mari kita ucapkan puji dan syukur kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala, Tuhan semesta alam yang Maha Esa, yang melimpahkan nikmat kesehatan, waktu dan karunia-Nya sehingga kita hari ini bersama-sama dapat mengikuti kegiatan ini. Salawat dan salam juga tak lupa kita selalu sampaikan kepada junjungan Nabi besar kita Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, karena beliau telah membimbing kita dari zaman jahiliyah menjadi zaman yang Islamiyah. Semoga kita kelak mendapat syafaat dari beliau sampai di akhir zaman. Amin. Bapak Ibu hadirin yang berbahagia, saya selaku Ketua Prodi Sistem Informasi mengucapkan selamat bergabung, selamat datang di Zoom ini, khususnya kepada selaku Ketua Prodi Sistem Informasi utama kita mengucapkan selamat alhamdulillah bergabung, beliau berlama datang di Zoom untuk, ini khususnya kepada selakunya Ketua Prodi Sistem Informasi utama kita mengucapkan selamat alhamdulillah beliau berlama datang di Zoom ini khususnya kepada selakunya Ketua Prodi Sistem Informasi utama kita mengucapkan selamat alhamdulillah walaupun saya berlama datang sama tahu khususnya kepada selakunya Ketua Prodi kami alhamdulillah Prodi Sistem Informasi masih diberi kesempatan untuk berbagi ilmu, karena yang hadir di Zoom ini bukan hanya dari sistem informasi, dosen-dosen di sekitaran Fakultas Sains dan Teknologi UIN Raden Fatah, alhamdulillah juga diikutin dari berbagai wilayah di Indonesia. Kuliah tamu ini merupakan satu rangkaian webinar yang telah kami lakukan dari awal, ya, mulai dari pandemik. Dan kegiatan kuliah tamu ini kegiatan kuliah tamu yang kedua. Yang pertama kami kuliah dengan tema yang kami angkat waktu itu mengenai tantangan dan peluang sistem informasi di era revolusi industri 4.0. Alhamdulillah di kesempatan hari ini saya kira ini ada benang merahnya. Kalau kemarin kita melihat tantangan dan peluang, sekarang diangkat lagi tema bagaimana implementasi sistem informasi di bidang bisnis. Karena mau tidak mau kalau membahas masalah revolusi industri, larinya pasti bagaimana mengoptimalkan suatu organisasi. Kalau organisasi bisa menyangkut kemana saja, tidak hanya organisasi dari dunia bisnis kerja, tapi bisa juga dari lingkungan pemerintahan atau dari masyarakat sendiri. Nah, sebagaimana kita ketahui bahwa peran sistem informasi itu mau tidak mau tidak bisa, harus kita hadapi, harus kita terima. Kalau tidak, kita akan menjadi tertinggal. Nah, sistem informasi adalah suatu sistem yang berinteraksi, yang dapat berinteraksi dari dan dengan lingkungannya. Tentunya melalui suatu siklus yang sering kita kenal dengan siklus sistem informasi atau IPO, input, proses, maupun output. Nah, proses ini akan menggambarkan bagaimana sistem memperoleh input dari luar, kemudian prosesnya menghasilkan suatu output, dan outputnya kembali menghasilkan suatu informasi yang lebih dikenal dengan informasi service. Nah, dalam bidang bisnis paling tidak ada tiga hal nanti peran utama dari sistem informasi tersebut. Yang pertama adalah bagaimana sistem informasi dapat mendukung suatu proses bisnis dan operasionalnya. Yang kedua adalah mendukung dalam pengambilan keputusan. Karena dalam pengambilan keputusan tentu membutuhkan banyak sekali informasi, maka informasi itu akan menjadi sangat mahal. Kemudian yang ketiga adalah bagaimana mendukung sistem informasi tersebut, mendukung suatu strategi untuk keunggulan suatu kompetitif. Nah, saya kira ketiga hal ini menjadi suatu hal yang penting dalam suatu organisasi. Nah, berkaitan dengan hal-hal tersebut, bagaimana implementasi sistem informasi dalam kehidupan kita, khususnya dalam dunia bisnis, alhamdulillah di tengah-tengah kita ini, dari tadi kita sudah sebut-sebutkan, narasumber kita dari tetangga jiran kita, walaupun jauh, tapi dekat sebenarnya kalau dari kita terbang sana cukup 1 jam. Saya kira dari CV beliau, kami di sini punya keyakinan bahwa Dr. Nur Asyikin Ali ini memang benar pakar di bidangnya. Bapak Ibu sekalian, tentu saya tidak akan berpanjang-panjang karena pembicara utama kita yang akan kita dengarkan. Dalam kesempatan ini, izinkan pula saya mengucapkan terima kasih kepada Dekan Fakultas Sains dan Teknologi, Wakil Dekan 1-2-3, Bapak Ibu dosen yang telah menjembatani sehingga kegiatan webinar ini dapat terlaksana. Tentu juga saya tidak lupa saya ucapkan sahabat kami, adik kami, Darussalam Eskom MCS. Beliau adalah salah satu kandidat doktor yang insya Allah sekarang lagi menyelesaikan tahap akhir studi S3-nya di Malaysia. Terima kasih Pak Darussalam telah menjembatani kami dengan Ibu Profesor Nur. Dan semoga studi beliau berjalan lancar dan cepat kembali mengabdikan, mengembangkan prodi sistem informasi di UIN Raden Patah Palembang. Selain izinkan pula saya menyampaikan maaf karena tidak ada manusia yang sempurna. Ada saja gangguan dari teknis ya. Kami dari saya mewakili prodi sistem informasi dan juga Fakultas Saintek memohon ampun kepada Allah dan mohon maaf bila ada di sana sini masih ada kekurangan. Marilah kita berdoa semoga kita dapat menyerap ilmu yang akan disampaikan oleh narasumber kita. Akhir kata tak lupa saya ucapkan terima kasih kepada semua pihak yang telah membantu, khususnya kepada narasumber kita Ibu Nur Asyikin. Sebagai penutup, saya akan menyampaikan pantun Sungai Musi di Kota Palembang. Airnya tenang, tandanya dalam. Para peserta, kami ucapkan selamat datang. Semoga pengetahuan kita semakin dalam. Billahi taufiq wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Baik, terima kasih kami ucapkan kepada Ketua Program Studi Sistem Informasi, Ibu Dr. Feni Purwani, M.Com. Bapak-Ibu hadirin yang berbahagia, saya sedikit coba cek sound kepada moderator kita, Ibu Rusmala. Apakah sudah hadir? Siap?
Siap, insya Allah.
Alhamdulillah. Dan juga narasumber utama kita, Ibu Nora Asikin. Cek sound, Bu. Mohon maaf. Baik. Bapak-Ibu hadirin yang masih dari narasumber utama kita, kami mohon kepada Ibu Associate Professor TS Dr. Nur Asikin Ali dari Universitas Tenaga Nasional Malaysia yang akan didampingi bersama dengan moderator kita, Ibu Rusmala Santi, M.Com. Untuk waktunya kami persilakan.
Baik, terima kasih Bapak Hafiz. Prof. Nur, apakah bisa mendengar suara saya?
Ya.
Baik, sebelumnya, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Wassalamualaikum. Anak nelayan menuju muara, mencari ikan dengan perahu. Para peserta hadirin semua, izinkan saya memperkenalkan pembicara dulu. Sebelumnya, saya sudah mendapat CV dari Ibu Associate Professor Teknologi Teknologi Profesional Dr. Nur Asikin Ali. Okay. Jadi Prof. Nur Asikin ini dari Universiti Tenaga Nasional Malaysia meraih gelar PhD-nya itu di Massey University, Palmerston North, New Zealand di bidang Information System. Kemudian sekarang menjabat sebagai Deputy Dean bidang Academic Quality and Student Affairs di College of Graduate Studies. Kalau award dan lain sebagainya itu banyak sekali dan maaf saya tidak bisa menyebutkan satu persatu ya mengingat waktu ya Prof. Nur ya. Tapi profesionalitas dari Prof. Nur itu sangat banyak dari reward dan penelitian di bidang sistem informasi yang sudah dilakukan Prof. Nur, terutama di bidang sistem informasi ya Prof. Nur ya. Kemudian belum lagi ke pengalaman yang lainnya sebagai supervisor PhD-nya. Oke, sepertinya tanpa berkata lebih jauh, silakan Prof. Nur untuk presentasi materi hari ini.
Terima kasih, Ibu Rusmala Santi. Okay, yang dihormati Dekan Fakultas Sains dan Teknologi UIN Radin Fatah Palembang, Dr. Munir M. Agi, Dekan 1, Dekan 2, Dekan 3, Dr. Feni Purwani, Ketua Program Studi Sistem Informasi, Ibu Rusmala Santi, terima kasih ya kerana menjemput saya untuk sharing knowledge with all the lecturers and students at UIN Radin Fatah. Saya amat bersyukur kerana diberi peluang, ini dinamakan takdir. Sebab saya bertemu dengan Darussalam semasa nak beli nasi lemak. Darussalam punya favorite food is nasi lemak. But now he said he is on diet. So he's no longer taking nasi lemak. Okay. Dan saya mengucapkan ribuan terima kasih kepada UIN Radin Fatah kerana memberi peluang kepada saya untuk kembali ke Palembang secara virtual. Okay, tahun lepas saya dah datang ke Palembang dengan UAGM. Okay, kita organise conference bersama-sama. Okay, saya datang untuk bagi talk macam mana nak develop research proposal, macam mana nak tulis academic papers. And then kita continue with conference together, collaboration UAGM. So insya Allah we will do the same with UIN Raden Fatah Palembang, insyaAllah. Okey. Untuk memulakan siri syarahan saya, knowledge sharing session. So I will use mixed language, BM and English also. Okay, I hope you don't mind. And untuk pensyarah-pensyarah dan pelajar-pelajar, okay, saya yang saya hormati, semoga ilmu yang saya akan berikan ini memberi manfaat sedikit pun tak apa. Ya, insyaAllah. Okay, saya akan share screen sekarang. Boleh nampak ke?
Tampak tu.
Ada Bu. Ada.
Ada tampak dah.
Implementing information system, the front page nampak ya?
Tampak.
Okay. Alright. So the topic given to me is implementing information system in business. Okay, so the introduction, I don't have to introduce myself sebab Guru Semala dah perkenalkan saya. Mungkin saya go into the detail about myself, kita boleh relate dengan information system at the end of the session. Okay, let me show you the table of content what I'm going to talk about today. So I'll give the introduction of information system, a little bit of the meaning of information system. Probably you have known already, but it's okay for us to really remind each other again about the definition of information system. Probably this is a good question for final exam. And then types of information system, the application of information system in organization. So how information system can help business, and also what are the benefits and challenges in implementing business information system. Then by the end of the session, I will include also unit 10 programs. So what kind of program that we offer for postgraduate? Saya difahamkan bahawa kebanyakan pensyarah-pensyarah di UIN Raden Fatah belum ramai lagi yang mempunyai PhD. So mungkin kita boleh buat collaboration where you actually register as PhD student secara virtual, then kita boleh have online supervision, dan saya akan bentangkan juga scholarship yang kita ada. Okay, peluang-peluang yang kita ada dari Unit 10. Okay, to start with, so I always ask my students the question, what is information system? So kalau kita tengok orang yang selalu bertanya itu adalah orang yang paling bijak, because dia seorang yang berfikir. Okay, kadang-kadang kita selalu tengok, oh orang, kenapa you tanya soalan, mungkin you bodoh. Tak, orang yang bertanya soalan adalah orang cerdik. So sebelum kita go through into the definition of information system, we take a look at what actually every day we have to deal with. Every day we are dealing with data. Okay, a lot of data comes from your university, from Facebook every day, and then from the organization. You go to hospital also, you have to deal with data. You go and buy food, you have to deal with data. You go to shopping, you have to deal with data. And this, the data come also from university about your student, your lecturer and so on. So this data actually is increasing. You can see the data is growing at 40% rate, near annual rate. Okay, reaching nearly 45 zillion bytes by 2030. No more million, but zillion bytes. So we are now is being surrounded by data every day. Sometimes we don't have time for ourselves, because we are, every day we look at that at our WhatsApps, we look at Facebook, all about the data. And this data need to be managed. If we don't manage properly, we will lose data, we lose students' record, we lose everything. Okay, so whether we like it or not, we have to manage our data. All right, so data need to be stored, data need to be categorized, data need to be sorted. So when students register everything in Raden Fatah, okay. So whether we like it or not, we have to register our data. Department or application, right? Department. So data needs to be stored, data students, need to be categorized, data needs to be sorted. So how do you want them to manage the students data? Register everything in Raden Fatah, so whether we like it or not, we have to register our data. Information system or application How do you want them to manage students? You can order all the things from online system. Okay? Boleh bayangkan tak? Itu dinamakan Allah Maha Pengasih dan Penyayang. Walaupun dia bawa kita ada musibah COVID-19, but we have to think positive. Bayangkan kalau COVID-19 dilahirkan semasa kita tak ada information system. Kita akan terperangkap di dalam rumah, tak boleh beli barang, tak boleh belajar. So sekarang walaupun kita ada COVID, tapi takdir Allah itu lebih baik. Allah lebih mengetahui. Dia bagi kita semasa information system, ada internet of things, ada Grab, ada everything. Dia memudahkan hidup kita. Okay, that is on the positive side. So cuma kita berdoa supaya Allah memudahkan hidup kita untuk menghadapi COVID-19. Tetapi kita tetap bersyukur dengan adanya information system ni membantu kita untuk menjalani kehidupan kita dan universiti tetap teruskan pembelajaran seperti biasa. Itu betapa pentingnya information system. Okay, let's see the definition of information system. Cuba fikirkan kalau pulang ke kampung, pelajar-pelajar pulang ke kampung, nenek tanya. Okey, kakak tanya, abang tanya, kakak tanya, program apa you ambil? Saya ambil information system. Apa itu information system? So how are you going to explain? So kalau dalam bahasa yang mudah, information system ni terdiri daripada kita ada komputer, tapi dalam komputer tu kita kena ada orang yang menguruskan komputer. Komputer tak boleh sendiri jalan. Kena ada orang dan kita kena ada proses. Apa tujuan komputer tu? Untuk membantu proses kita menjadi lebih efisien. Kalau kakak mahu membeli barang, kita guna information system, kakak boleh order online. Bagi contoh itu. Okay, in sebagai formal definition, I would say that okay, information system is a collection of components. Okay, because it's not about computer only. Okay, that work together. There must be, they need each other. Okay, to provide information. So that is the purpose of having this information system, because we need information. Seperti Dr. Munir said just now, informasi untuk membantu petani-petani. Okay, informasi untuk membantu masyarakat yang belum faham apa itu COVID-19. Mereka masih rasa COVID-19 tak exist. Okay, so dengan bantuan information system, maklumat-maklumat dapat disalurkan pada masyarakat-masyarakat di kampung. Okey, masyarakat-masyarakat yang jauh yang belum ada dapat maklumat. So that is how important the information system. So information system will help in operations and management of an organization. Okey. So when we have this information system, we are not focusing only on the technology. So the technology, we can talk about hardware, software, the data, okay? The data, the software is to tell hardware what to do. Okay, we have many hardware now, we have software now. Compared to last time during my old days, hardware is very slow, so now it's very, very fast. Okay, and you have many software, many application system that is to tell hardware what to do. And we need the data. Definitely we need the data because the purpose of having computer is to process the data. And then in order to complete the process, you must have people. Who are the people? The programmer, system analyst. You must also have users. Users of the data, users who give the input. And then, of course, the process. So information system is to make the process efficient. So the process is the activities that you have every day. For example, in your university, you have application process. So when the students want to study at your university, they will apply. Can you imagine last time when we had application without information system? If we had 500 students, how do you want to have students to apply? You have to fill in the form, kertas, menggunakan banyak kertas. Kertas harus dihantar ke university. It may take 1 week to post. Then you have tunggu lagi. So it will take a long time. So sekarang dengan information system, you punya application boleh dapat masa seminggu. dalam masa boleh dapat masa 3 hari. Kalau dekat UNITAN dalam masa 3 hari, kalau fulfill requirement, we can give offer letter. That is how fast information system can help the process. So, tadi Ibu Doktor, saya tak ingat ya, dia ada menerangkan mengenai input, di mana data is processed dan mengeluarkan output. So output is the information based on the data that you give. So that means if the input is wrong, the output is wrong. That is why information system is very particular about validation of data. Okay, kalau dulu, zaman dulu kita guna information kita melalui e-buku. Okay, kita tulis nama kita dekat buku, mungkin ada kesilapan. The next time kita datang lagi, kita tulis lagi nama kita, kita tulis alamat kita. Okay, menyebabkan benda itu lambat, tertangguh dan sebagainya. Jadi bila ada information system, kita bagi the data, kita fill in the data, kita proses, kita dapat output. So the students apply, okay, that is the input. Then we process the input from the student, data, alamat, nama, and then the output we get is the list of students that have applied. So when they can tanya, okay, how many students do we have this semester? So we can refer to our information system. I hope the student can follow me. Everyone can follow me?
Yes, Prof. Yes.
Alright. Okay. Alright. Okay. So the information system kita di, ini gambar Putrajaya. Kita punya Perdana Menteri. Bangunan Perdana Menteri, di mana Perdana Menteri, pejabat Perdana Menteri di sini dengan menteri-menteri. Okey, government gunakan information system for public services. Okey, untuk kira tax dan banyak lagi macam now we have e-filing. Untuk tax cukai kita ada e-filing. Information system where isi borang melalui online sahaja. Kalau dulu nak pergi pergi bayar cukai kena beratur panjang. Sekarang tak perlu, kita isi borang online dan terus bayar. Alright. And university juga. Okay, ini gambar betul ke gambar UIN Raden Fatah? Do I get the picture?
Yeah, it's an old building. It's an old building, but
So, also juga saya cuma nak relate bahawa kalau information system telah diimplementasikan di Universiti UIN Raden Fatah, maka proses lebih more efficient, the session lebih more efficient, classes can be handled more efficiently, kurang clash. Okay, banyak subjek kita boleh offer dengan adanya information system. Okay, and hospital, kalau ada kita ada hospital, klinik-klinik, mungkin ada klinik-klinik yang belum ada information system, kita boleh tengok certain klinik yang they don't have information system, dia punya document is very thick. So if you go and say, okay, what's your name? And then you tell the cashier there, okay, the administrative there, you say that, okay, my name is Nora Shikin. They have to go through very thick document to find my name, the card, okay, the history, the record of my medical records. So that is not efficient. So if you have information system, I just tell my name and then search. Okay, this is your name, this is your medical record. So this medical record can be forwarded to the doctor. So you don't have to print. So you save environment. Okay, doctor can look at the medical record online. So this is how information system can help the world nowadays. Alright, so secara basic ya, in terms of from academic perspective. Okay, information system, there are a few types of information system. The bottom one is called transaction processing system. So transaction processing system actually is to record and process business transactions. Kalau kita pergi bank, kita keluarkan duit, itu namakan transaction processing system. And then it move on to a tactical decision where actually this is to help ketua-ketua jabatan dan juga pihak-pihak management untuk membuat keputusan melalui decision support system dan juga information system. So that by the end of the day, I want to see the report. For example, head of department say, I want to see the report of the sales today. How much sales we have got today? Okay, so we have received loan from student to apply scholarship, for example. So how to decide? Then you can use decision support system. So decision support system, in business organization, they assist managers in making complex decision. For example, in banking sector, they use decision support system, for example, loan. Okay, you want to apply loan, you have to have a certain requirement. So if this person with this salary, then the application is approved. So instead of having manager to decide, so we can use this decision support system. Decision support system will approve the, okay, but will approve who actually can apply loans. And then they have executive information system. That is the upper level for top management to decide for strategic decision. Okay, for the next 5 years, based on this data, so what do you want to achieve? For example, you in Raden Fatah. So what do you want to be? You want to have to be one of the top ranking of Islamic university that focus on IT in Asia, on Southeast Asia, for example, or in the world, you never know. All right, so this is how you can use the information system to help your university to move forward, to advance. Okay, there are other applications of information system nowadays. If you notice, you can see the drone here. So the drone is to deliver the medicines to patients at rural areas. So this is how important information system with the current situation now. Okay, you can't move a lot, so you can't go to hospital because due to COVID. So what they do is they deliver the medicines through drones. Okay, and I have seen that they use drone to go and detect who actually do not follow SOP. They don't follow social distancing. They go to shopping center ramai-ramai, so drone can detect. So we have information systems in healthcare now. We have mobile health. We have telemedicine. Okay, all actually have, it's like coincidence, with the advancements of information system, then we have COVID. We have telemedicine. Last time telemedicine, people do not like telemedicine. Telemedicine is where you provide treatment, diagnosis through distance. Okay, you don't have to go to the clinic. You can contact the doctor through online. All right. So at that time, telemedicine was not popular. Now, with due to COVID-19, telemedicine is one of the most popular application system that people like to use. Okay, you can stay at home, you can contact your doctor, doctor can do diagnosis for you. Then now you can also track location, GPS, where are you now? Like now I am working from home, so I have to log in and tell me, okay, I am actually working from home, so the Uniten actually have my GPS to track the location. Yeah, and then we have now the facilities of web conferencing. This is part also of applications of information system where people get together at long distance. There is no geographical barrier, even though Palembang is far away. With Zoom, Microsoft Teams, webinars, we are very close to each other. This is example how actually the information system can help us. And then you have online learning. Kids, children, they cannot go to school due to COVID-19. They have Khan Academy. They have Coursera. Coursera, if pelajar-pelajar mahu menambah ilmu, extra courses, there are free courses untuk IT. Mungkin boleh register untuk Coursera. Universiti-universiti kat US, dia provide free courses. Contohnya nak belajar data science, boleh register dekat Coursera. They provide free courses to certain level. Okay, and then remote working, okay, work from home, everyone is working from home. So if you don't have this online platform, you cannot contact each other, you cannot contact your lecturer. So by having information system, you have the facilities. Okay, university also, you don't close university. Okay, university can still get income. Like Uniten, we actually have the income from student because we are private university. So the university has to move forward. Okay, we have to carry out our activities as usual. So you provide remote working, you provide online learning. And then nowadays, if you notice, it's very popular. I'm not sure sama ada kat Palembang e-wallet is popular. Macam mana e-wallet kat Palembang, is that popular?
Yes, it's quite popular. We use
popular.
Yeah. Oppo, just like
Okay, and this e-wallet in Malaysia is very popular. We just go and use our mobile phone and scan the QR code, we can pay, provided that you have money. No money, no talk. Okay, so even though you have a mobile phone, whatever, if you don't have money, you can buy anything. All right. Okay, so this information just to facilitate, not is the main thing in your life, but it is facilitate your life to make your life easier. Okay, in business, how information system is used in business? For nowadays, we can see that people are jobless. Okay, they have a large number of people who lost their job due to COVID-19. Pilots have lost their job. The airlines have stopped. So what happened is, they pilot do business to make your life easier. What type of business you can do with information system? You have eBay, where you can lay long, auction your products in eBay, and then you can have Grab car. Dalam Grab application system, you have Grab car. You can make payment through Grab. You can transfer money through Grab. Okay, and then you have Amazon. Okay, Amazon is electronic mall. You can go and shopping. Okay, for in Amazon, you cannot go to your mall now due to COVID, so you can shop online. I use a lot of online shopping because I don't go out most of the time to avoid COVID. And then we have Alibaba. Okay, those people who are businessmen, they want to sell their products. They call it e-marketplace. Okay, they can put their products at Alibaba and people can buy. So the one is famous now is Shopee. Okay, Shopee, last time if you want to buy the product, we have to go to physical shop. Then only you can get the product. Now we can go through Shopee, and that Shopee actually can give me product from Indonesia, can give me product from other parts of the world. There is no geographical barrier. And these people, the sellers also, they don't have to pay rent for physical shop. So what they do, only put the products on marketplace, on Shopee, they can sell the product. This is one way also to increase income. For example, petani-petani, mungkin dia boleh letak fresh ataupun frozen chickens, frozen food dekat online business. So they can deliver this online business, they can deliver to us. So information system boleh membantu petani-petani memajukan produk-produk mereka. Dan juga dekat masa COVID dekat Malaysia, kita ada MCO selama 3 bulan dari bulan Mac hari tu. Kita banyak order fresh food, fresh fish, fresh seafood online. Ini juga membantu petani-petani, farmers, okay, fishermen untuk jual dia punya produk. Okay. And then we have touch and go. In Malaysia, we have RFID. That means you don't use card. We still have cards, but we have improved a little bit by having RFID where you just go through the toll without having to touch the card. Okay, this is how actually information system can be used in business. So those people who are involved in touch and go also, they have a lot of money through touch and go cards or selling RFID. Okay, so what are the implications? So what are the implications of information system in business? They improve customer experience. What do you feel if you go to the shop and you have to wait for 5 hours to get products, so you don't like, right? So by having information system, customer satisfaction is improved. They feel that, okay, I like to go this shop. Okay, it's very fast. The payment is very fast. Everything is efficient. And then you can respond to customer demands. Okay, like you in Radin Fatah, your customers is students. Okay, so you can have a good response to customer demands. That means the students' demand. So for example, students ask what kind of subjects that you offer, what kind of programs that you offer in UIN, Radin Fatah. So you can just go through information system and you can respond to the students very fast, potential student. Okay, we have offered IT program, for example. This is how much that you have to pay. Okay, this is scholarship that you offer. Everything is very fast. So that is to respond to customer demands. And then you can expand e-commerce and m-commerce. Okay, for example, I have given you many examples, huh, because we have many jobless people nowadays. Farmers, fishermen, okay, they can expand their products through e-commerce and e-commerce. Innovation, and through information system, you get the ideas from other people. Based on the ideas from other people's maklumat disalurkan, you have the ideas how to improve. Okay, they can have, let's say for example, you see, oh, these people make a cake. Okay, I want to improve, I want to provide the business, I want to improve cake to be more innovative. Then new products also can be sold on online commerce. So all this actually by the help of information system. Increase effectiveness in business process. So your registration system is very effective. Your application system very effective. Classes, registration of classes, enrollment of students are very effective. Student can, let's say you want to start the semester in January. So, but through information system, the information can make sure that the student can register for subjects in that class. Okay, so if they want five subjects are registered for them. This is show how information system can increase effectiveness. Okay, besides that, improve decision making. Okay, information system. In Unitem, Vice Chancellor always ask for the data, because we want to get the ranking. Okay, later I talk about Unitem. So, you in Radin Fatah, so if your university, if to apply for ranking or you want to be in top Asia, probably your vice chancellor wants the data. So this is how actually can improve the decision making. In terms of collaboration with other universities, so through information system, you can get the data. And then strategic and competitive advantage. Like Unitem, we have many competitors, okay? Many universities in Malaysia. So you have to compete. How to compete? Through information system. So that is to give strategic competitive advantage. So similarly, untuk UN Raden Fatah, you also can use information system to compete with other universities. When we talk competition, it's not that secara tak elok. Competition secara baik. Kita improve kita punya registration system, kita improve kita punya sistem di dalam universiti di mana memudahkan pihak-pihak stakeholders untuk universiti kita, maka kita boleh compete with other universities. Sometimes using information system juga boleh membantu kita untuk go to from the lowest level to the highest level in the world. Sekarang ni kalau kita tengok macam universiti-universiti yang bagus sekarang semua di luar negara. Okay, so sekarang kita nak improve universiti-universiti di Southeast Asia, di negara-negara yang developing countries untuk lebih maju through information system. So information system juga akan help us survive in business. Kalau you nak compete dengan other universities, tapi kita punya sistem selalu down, tak dapat masuk, tak dapat student, tak dapat register, then business is very hard to survive. Okay, and then also information system, you integrate functions and business processes. So whatever functions, activities in your organization, in your university, in business organization, you must make ensure that your business processes are correct. So all the information system is to improve business processes, not the other way around. When we have information system, the purpose is to improve our processes. Kalau selama ni proses kita untuk meluluskan sesuatu application mengambil masa seminggu, sekarang dalam masa sehari kita boleh approve application. Alright. Okay. Now we can see that e-business is common. Okay, this is how information system help in business organization. So this is where you use the technology and internet to improve business processes in organization. So e-business now become a platform, okay, that coordinate between suppliers and stakeholders. So now we can see the malls in Malaysia, we have a big grocery store. In Malaysia, we have Tesco, we have Giant. So all these people, now they provide home delivery services where the customers stay at home and order groceries from through their platform. And they just deliver the products to us. Okay, other example is e-commerce. Okay, e-commerce and business almost the same. It's just the term is different because e-commerce is more on the supplier, involve wholesalers, okay, retailers, contoh Amazon, Walmart. I'm not sure kedai-kedai di Palembang macam mana. Adakah kedai-kedai di Palembang menggunakan e-commerce?
Yeah.
Okay, apa yang saya bagi contoh ni, ada ya,
ada
e-commerce di Palembang.
Ya.
Yeah. Dia provide online hantar ke rumah ya. Kita boleh order online, dia hantar ke rumah produk.
Ya, mobile commerce.
Mobile.
Mobile commerce. Okay. Jadi bisa beli keperluan sayur mayur.
Sebenarnya itu membantu ya petani-petani. Kalau dulu susah sangat nak jual sayur sebab petani kena guna orang tengah. Bila guna orang tengah, produk akan jadi lebih mahal. So, sekarang kalau dia petani-petani ada ilmu macam mana dapat menjual dia punya produk secara direct, then kita boleh bantu dia dari segi e-commerce. Okay, maka ekonomi sesuatu negara akan improve. Ekonomi individual satu kampung atau bandar akan improve due this to information system. Kalau kat Malaysia, saya tak tahu you are whether you are familiar with Sugu Pavitra. This person, okay, I would like to share because it's very unique. She is nobody. She is just Sugu and Pavitra are husband and wife. They are Indians. Okay, in Malaysia we have multiracial. So their income is only, they are very poor. They don't have much money. So they just grow vegetables. So kalau tak ada duit, pergi go fishing. So now what they do, they use YouTube to show how to cook. How to cook and using bahasa Malaysia. Walaupun dia India. So dia mendapat respon about 1 million. And sekarang dia punya income adalah through YouTube. Just by sharing recipe. Resipi dia biasa-biasa. Macam resipi kari ikan. Tetapi mendapat respon yang begitu baik. Satu juta. And kalau dulu dia dapat satu ringgit per day pun dia susah, dia cakap. Sekarang dia dapat income, passive income from Google due to YouTube, from YouTube. Itu example macam mana information system can help people do business, can improve the economy of individual. So kalau kita negara Islam, kita nak bantu melalui zakat. So kalau kita dapat improve kita punya business using information system, kita become richer and kita lebih keluarkan zakat lebih banyak dan membantu orang-orang lain yang kurang bernasib baik. So that is how actually information system can help the business. Yeah. Okay, M-commerce, mobile commerce. Kalau kita tengok mobile commerce macam Ibu Rosmala mention tadi, mobile commerce ini through handheld devices, through your mobile phone. Kalau lapar aja tekan button, kemudian sampailah makanan. Saya tak tahu saya nak order pempek kat mana. Dapat sampai ke sini. Kalau kat sini saya tak tahu kat mana kedai yang ada jual Palembang food. Okay, but definitely cannot fly from Palembang here, right? If I order through my mobile. Okay, so total revenue from M-commerce, kalau you betul-betul buat business through M-commerce now, is 423 million by 2022. That means we have the opportunities. So macam kita yang memang dah ada ilmu information system, mungkin kita boleh share ilmu information system kepada masyarakat-masyarakat di kampung. Macam mana dia yang dapat menjana pendapatan melalui e-commerce. Okay. Okay, so what are the benefits of e-business? Eliminates time limitations. Okay. Kita tak perlu concern about masa, tak perlu keluar untuk membeli, spend 1 or 2 hours outside, kita boleh order online. Removes geographical limitations, kita boleh order from Germany, product from US, product from Palembang. Kalau ada produk-produk yang bagus kat Palembang, boleh kita order, hantar ke Malaysia. Cost reduction, it is cheaper. Kenapa cheaper? Kita tak perlu ada kedai. Kita tak perlu bayar sewa kedai, kita tak perlu ada building. Okay. Mungkin barang-barang tu kita letak kat rumah ataupun kita ada sewa satu gudang. Tak perlu bulan-bulan, hanya space, kita sewa space saja. So it's allow flexibility for customers. So dia memberi peluang sama ada you nak kecikkan your business ataupun scale up your business. So benda ini e-business through by using information through e-business. So you don't have to think much about investing in your physical building, investing in hiring staff. Kita kurangkan salesman, sales girls, okay, through e-business. Allah Allah. Okay. Next is cloud-based information system. So, cloud-based information system is actually using cloud. Using cloud means you are not using your own space. For example, server. If you want to buy server with a very big storage, that is very, very expensive. Probably we cannot afford. So what we do is we rent a space at the cloud. Okay, so we rent data storage on the internet. Okay, they have a very large storage devices. So the example, you can rent a space from Amazon Web Services. You can also have a Google application engine as a service for to as your application engine. And for example, Microsoft 365. Last time, Uniten used Microsoft Exchange. The space is very limited. I receive email thousands per day. So always I have the notification that it is full, it is full, it is full. And most of the time the emails are rejected. So now we have shifted to Microsoft 365, which is cloud-based information system. So now I have 8,000 emails in my box. I don't have to worry about the space anymore. Okay, because the space is very, very large. We have paid for Microsoft, the space for Microsoft 365. That means we use the space from the clouds, okay? So this is one way to save money because the space, the storage is very expensive. Okay, so what are the benefits of cloud computing for business? Okay, if you in Radin Fatah has not yet used cloud computing, probably it is a good suggestion that you can use clouds rather than normal storage, okay? And you can look into getting cloud for your university to get the space. So cloud computing, they provide services in terms of the storage. They so provide services in terms of server. You don't have to buy many servers. Okay, you have to spend so much money for the servers. And then you have applications on cloud computing that can use, for example, Microsoft 365, email from cloud computing, Microsoft Teams also from cloud computing. You have also database from cloud computing. Okay, so there are a number of benefits of cloud computing that you can use. So we thank those developers of cloud computing for actually helping most of business organizations. So this is one way, actually, example of innovative product. Okay, last time we concentrated on buying a lot of computers. We're buying a lot of storage. But now with cloud computing, you can use the space from cloud computing. So that means you can work from anywhere. Last time, if I use Microsoft Exchange, if I go overseas, oh, I cannot access the server. So now I can go anywhere. I can still access the emails through cloud computing. Okay. So Internet of Things. Internet of Things is another example of how the recent innovative emerging technologies to help for businesses. Macam mana university boleh guna Internet of Things, for example. Okay, Internet of Things, kalau secara kat universiti kita ada sampah-sampah yang perlu dikutip, you can use sensor. Internet of Things ni dia ada sensor RFID where you can provide notification, okay, sampah ini telah penuh. Okay, the data will be sent back and then orang yang in charge kata, okay, this is the time to go and collect sampah. Okay, so this is a very simple example. And then Internet of Things boleh alert kita apa-apa masalah di jalan raya. For example, kita ada longkang tersumbat. Then student nampak, ada longkang tersumbat dekat tepi universiti ni, boleh menyebabkan nyamuk Aedes. So they can use the application to report back through Internet of Things. So this is how Internet of Things can actually help the businesses, right? So we have ways now. Last time we use map, paper. Now you can switch on your mobile phone. You use Waze, they can direct you. Okay, like when I was in Palembang, I use a lot of Grab car. Then at the same time, I use Waze because I say, oh, whether this person is actually going to the right destination. So I use Waze to detect the GPS. All right. Oh, my keyboard problem. Okay. Save cost. Okay, IoT can save cost, can reduce downtime, can save cost in terms of number of people. So sometimes kita buang masa, kita guna resources, pekerja-pekerja untuk pergi check longkang ni macam mana. So before they come and check, we use IoT so that the public people can use that to alert. The person in charge bagi tahu, kata okay, kat sini ada jalan-jalan yang rosak. Then through the system they can get the notification, they come and fix, rather than they come first and check then go back. So this IoT is very very helping us to be very efficient. And customer retention, okay, through IoT most of the things are automated now. Everything is customers nowadays, they want everything fast. Right, so through IoT sekarang ni kalau lalu dekat Malaysia tol, kita guna RFID, semua nak cepat. Kita tak nak guna dah touch and go, nak bayar pun through mobile phone, semua cashless. So this is how the IoT you can help the business organization. Okay, other specialized information system. Okay, for your information, knowledge management system. Knowledge management system actually is the system that store knowledge, which is different from normal information system. All this while we have been talking about information system, sistem maklumat untuk store data, untuk proses become maklumat. Tapi sekarang kita nak tengok macam mana ada information system untuk store knowledge ni. Maksud dia, kalau kita ada, okay, for example, dekan Dr. Munir, katalah dia nak pension suatu hari nanti. Sebelum dia pension, kita go and capture his knowledge. Dia punya pengalaman mengendalikan fakulti, pengalaman dia sebagai pensyarah. Then you store that knowledge in YouTube, okay, in the electronic book. That is example of knowledge management system. Okay, that is very, now knowledge management is the current one, because we don't want to repeat the solution. The solution is there. Kita dah guna pengalaman dari dekan macam mana nak handle faculty. So when there come a new dean wants to take over, he can go and refer to the experience of this Dr. Munir's experience through YouTube or through ebook. Okay, but he, Dr. Munir, has to share his knowledge first. Okay, like what I'm sharing now is part of knowledge management system, because I am sharing my knowledge. You can record my presentation and you can play back to the students, to other students. That is part of knowledge management system. While for artificial intelligence, you know, artificial intelligence now also in current demand, if you want to focus on artificial intelligence, where it emulates, they emulates people. We have robots now, bibit robots, kita panggil bibit robots. Kita ada robot vacuum. Itu semua example of artificial intelligence. The intelligence tetapi artificial, bukan manusia punya intelligence, because manusia punya intelligence is fitrah dari Allah, dia bagi kat kita, kan. So this is make it artificial, that means the product that we invent is to hanya meniru intelligence of people, macam robot. Tapi tak dapat menggantikan manusia, sebab manusia dijadikan oleh pencipta dalam keadaan yang unik. Brain kita memang unik. Dan expert system adalah sistem di mana menyimpan segala kepakaran. For example, expert system is used a lot in healthcare. How expert system is used in healthcare? For example, if you have headaches, okay, you have headaches, you feel that, okay, you feel like fever. So you access expert system will ask you, how can I help you? then you say, I am sick. Then the expert system will ask you, what are the symptoms? So you can give temperature macam ni, okay, degrees macam ni, then the expert system will give solution. Expert system will not replace doctors, but expert system will give solution for simple diagnosis. Mungkin you tak perlu pergi ke klinik, dia hanya perlu, dia cakap, oh mungkin kekurangan vitamin C. Itu dia expert system. Tetapi dalam counseling expert system also digunakan. Kalau ada student, for example, student bagi tahu expert system, dia assess, I cannot study. So expert system will provide solutions. Okay, but beside that, you still need to see human being because sometimes you need to talk. Okay, virtual reality. Virtual reality is also one of the current demands where actually you can use the system to understand the real life situation in virtually. For example, you want to understand how jantung works. Macam mana jantung itu, perjalanan jantung, darah dalam jantung. So you can capture the heart and put as virtual reality. So you can see that, oh, it is a reality but it is virtual. Macam you nak belajar cara fly aeroplane, you don't have to go and fly aeroplane, but you can use the system of virtual reality, okay, simulation, then you feel that you are actually in the aeroplane while you are not moving at all. Okay, so there are a few dia punya alat, tools dia that you can use then to make sure to make you feel like you are a pilot, but actually you are not moving at all. You just use the system, but the system is making you like you are a pilot. You can fly from Malaysia, from KL to Palembang, for example. So that is use virtual reality. So this is a very good project. If your university want to go into this project, into a final year project for student IF, so you can go into virtuality, you can go to explore how virtuality can help those society, community. Okay. So in the end, so what are the benefits of business information system? Okay, in general, I have touched a lot. Operational efficiency, definitely. Okay, reduce cost, improve decision making. Bila kita nak buat satu keputusan itu, kita refer kepada information system. Kita kena ada data bila nak buat keputusan. Kita katalah kita nak buat keputusan, kita nak tambah intake student. Okay, kita nak advertise, kita nak promote you in to Malaysian student. Okay, so Malaysian student, how many Malaysian student you want to attract to come to UN Raden Fatah? So you can use information system. Based on this data, okay, you can have increase the capacity, increase your classroom, increase the subjects, right? Increase the lecturers. So all this based on the data in order to make decision. Okay, and one thing about information system, always follow the requirements of the users. We don't develop information system just for the sake of developing. What you have to do, you must understand first what the users want. Okay, so then when the users want this, they give the requirements, we understand the requirements, only you can see the effectiveness of information system. What are the challenges? Okay, while we are talking about the good things about information system, there are always challenges. Cultural shift. Kalau boleh imagine, kalau kita suruh petani-petani untuk involve dalam mobile commerce, very hard sebab they are not used to cultural shift. They call it cultural to adapt to the culture. And then employees, very hard to adopt. First time online meeting, the first time we use Zoom, the first time we use Team, we are not actually comfortable. We do not know how to conduct the meeting or online lecture through this Zoom meeting or Teams meeting, because we need to use Teams. So this is the issues with adoption. Some people, they give up easily with technology, right? So the management must do something. Let's say for example, lecturers, they are not really comfortable using online. So they have, these lectures must be provided with training. And then other part of business information system, of course, The first time you want to implement, it involves very expensive. The first time you want to buy computer system, definitely you have to have money. Okay, you have to have funds. The resistance to change. Students, they don't want to change to online lecture. They still say, oh, I want to go to classroom. I want to see my lecturers. But in this situation, students have to adapt to the change. This is one of the challenge, resistance to change. So in Malaysia also, we have the same challenges. Some students, they don't even access online classes, even though they have the facilities. And then other issues, okay, once you have the application, you need to hire people. So do we have enough experts? Do we have enough people with that knowledge? So that is the function of university, to produce human capital. For example, kita ada pelajar-pelajar sekarang dekat universiti kat Palembang yang ambil IT, for example. So these people are the one that is going to help to develop their application system untuk mengatasi kekurangan pekerja-pekerja dalam bidang IT, especially Muslims. Right? So kalau university macam Raden Fatah, you have quite a number of students taking IT that can develop the system later, it can help improve Palembang, can help the society of Palembang, community, poor people can be can improve the economy. Okay, so this is the challenge now because we don't have many Muslims that are involved in IT. Kebanyakannya dari bukan Islam. Okay, so we want to improve our economy, Islamic economy through information system. And then also all the other ethics and security issues. Yes, people will hack the system. The more sophisticated you have, the more data you reveal. So you have the problem of if you expose your data through mobile, people can hack your credit cards, people, because you have to give the credit card number to your Shopee in order to purchase online. Then it could be security issues. Okay. How much time do I have?
Bu Mala.
How much time do I have?
Masih berapa ini, Bu?
About 5 minutes.
About 5 minutes, Bu.
Yeah, because we have a lot of questions, Prof. Nur.
Okay, because I want to show, okay. Probably I just want more business process, very important. I want to show, just a little bit more. Okay, I want to show, to share with student about IT or IS specialization. Okay, those people, those student, pelajar-pelajar yang ada sekarang mengambil IT or IS, ya. Okay, apa specialization? In case one day you want to specialize or you want to go out and to seek for jobs. So you can have now Internet of Things. You can focus on Internet of Things. You can have artificial intelligence, web applications, software engineering, networking, security, data science. You can become data analyst. Okay, you do a data analytics. You can become security administrators. You can become network engineer. Okay. So later I will share my experience, how actually from my own experience in industry and also as the lecturer. Okay, job scope based on personality. Okay, kalau pelajar rasa dia analytical, mungkin dia boleh become business analytics consultant. If you are creative, you can have web development. Okay, develop websites. You can be freelance. Sekarang ni freelance is very profitable. Provided that you are very expert in web development. Extrovert ni yang dia suka keluar. Then become IT manager, product manager. Introvert ni suka duduk depan komputer saja. Okay, malu nak keluar. Then boleh ambil programming atau IT security. Other jobs are system administrator, network administrator or help desk. Okay, so computing among the top 10 fastest growing major. Okay, so we have like 150,000 job openings in the world. So one in every two jobs actually in computing. So pelajar-pelajar yang ambil IS memang senang dapat kerja. So I want to share what are the programs we have in UNITEN. Kalau pensyarah-pensyarah dekat UN Raden Fatah untuk further studies, we have Doctor Philosophy in Information and Communication Technology. We also have Master of Information Technology by Research. Kalau belum ada Master, kalau dah ada Master buat PhD, kita ada PhD in Information and Communication Technology. Saya sendiri ada 6 PhD student sekarang, okay, dalam PhD in ICT. Okay, we also have coursework untuk master, maksud dia kita ada mix attend classes dengan research untuk IT dan software engineering. Dan juga structure C, that means structure C tu only classes with a little credit of a project for MBA. Okay, master in engineering management, master of energy management. Okay, I want to share you the Universiti Tenaga Nasional, the two videos. Can you hear?
Yes, we can hear you. Sounds great.
That is UNITEN, Universiti Tenaga Nasional. One day you will come to UNITEN. Okay, inshallah you will be invited to UNITEN.
I mean,
yes. This is Faculty IT. This is apartment for students.
Okay.
This is sports center and this is the stadium. Wow. If a student like to cycle lah. This is masjid. We have hotel.
Hotel.
Okay, and now we are ranking among 168 in Asia ranking. Okay, another one. Do you have videos here? Oh, they have videos. Okay, next. This is the environment on UNITEN campus. So this is UNITEN campus. It's my office in the blue building. Okay, so this is UNITEN campus. And one more, I want to share you the student UNITEN, how the life in UNITEN is. You can see.
My name is Faisal. I'm from Morocco. I really wanted to be a psychiatrist, but my love to physics drove me to engineering. UNITEN is producing one of the best graduates all over the place. I started searching about Malaysia, started hearing more, I started reading about UNITEN. And I felt that it was really interesting. So being here is a challenge. I love to make myself as busy as I can. So I'll do a lot of futsal, football, and gym and swimming is number one in terms of time consumption after university. I'm trying to keep myself as healthy as I can. I'm making my breakfast if I'm working out early.
There is a student apartment.
If I'm not, then I want to head directly to classes. And after finishing up my
library,
I'll be having already my gym bag packed. So from there, directly to the gym, doing some workout. Most probably, I'll be leaving gym around 9 or 10. I'll be having a few hours left for me to catch up with some studies and definitely. Yeah. So far, being in Italy is a great, great chapter of my life.
Okay, so what can we offer to you? UNITEN scholarship for master and PhD study. It's not a full scholarship, but we provide like certain amount of money to help you to further study. So we have for we call it postgraduate excellence scholarship and postgraduate talent scholarship. So you can apply if you're interested to do PhD with us or master's with us. So now you don't have to worry about coming to UNITEN because we can do online. Because due to COVID, nobody is allowed to travel. But you can apply online and we can have a long distance learning, online supervision. So those interested, you can contact me if you're interested to further your study in UNITEN. Okay. Yeah, I just want to share what mengenai tuntut ilmu ya. Daripada Abu Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu bahwasanya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bersabda, siapa yang menempuh satu jalan untuk mencari ilmu pengetahuan maka Allah memudahkan baginya satu jalan untuk menuju ke syurga. Jadi kita menuntut ilmu mengharapkan keridaan Allah supaya ilmu-ilmu yang kita pelajari, ilmu-ilmu information system, kita dapat IT, kita dapat membantu orang-orang lain. Okey, memudahkan orang lain, sebab Allah, kalau kita memudahkan kehidupan orang lain, Allah akan memudahkan kehidupan kita. Okey, kita question and answers now.
Okay, thank you Prof. Insyaallah bermanfaat ilmunya. Jadi Prof,
sorry for taking so long.
It's okay. It's a lot of knowledge we receive from you. Thank you. Okay, before question and answers, saya mau ngerangkum dulu apa saja yang sudah dijelasin sama Prof Nur Asikin ya. Jadi Prof Nur Asikin sudah menjelaskan tentang sistem informasi di dunia bisnis dan apa saja yang bisa dimasukin sistem informasi dalam dunia bisnis, dan terutama sistem informasi juga dapat mengubah budaya dan cara kita berbisnis, dan sistem informasi juga bisa merasuki di setiap lapisan dari bisnisnya, mulai dari top level management, middle dan lower management. Jadi kayaknya kita langsung ke tanya jawab ya Prof, karena pertanyaannya banyak sekali. Banyak sekali. Jadi melalui chat dulu, kalau misalnya ada yang mau bertanya langsung silakan raise hand ya para peserta. Saya akan membacakan dulu. Pertama dari Wahyu Oktiawan yang bertanya mengenai bagaimana cara membuat sistem informasi agar bisa cocok dengan tempat implementasinya. Do you understand the question? Or should I?
Maksudnya sistem information system to fit tempat implementasi. Yeah. Apa maksud tempat implementasi?
Bagaimana sistem informasi itu bisa digunakan? Ya, yeah. It fit. Can it fit the? Can we fit the information system to a business? How to make it fit?
First. Thank you for the question. Very good question. First, you understand the process. First, of course, the process. What kind of process that you want to improve? Apa benda activity that you want to implement? Baru kita bina information system untuk fit the business process. Kalau kita buat kedai, kita buat kedai tu kita kata kita ada kedai kecil. Alright? Tapi kita nak involve dalam mobile apps, okay, mobile business. So first, you have to understand first apa yang kita nak buat. What is your objective? What is the goal? So once you have the goal, only you can have the information system. Please remember, information system is only a tool. A tool to facilitate, alat yang memudahkan sesuatu perkara. So kalau kita ada proses, kita macam mana kita nak bagi proses tu efficient. Then kita baru ambil information system. Then information system kena align with the process.
Okay.
Banyakkan projek-projek fail sebab tak ikut proses.
Okay. Saya terjemahin dulu untuk jawabannya. Jadi sebenarnya sistem informasi itu mengikuti proses atau hal apa yang mau dimasukkan sistem informasinya. Jadi kalau misalnya seperti yang dijelasin sama Prof. Menteri akhir, bahwa sistem informasi itu mengikuti kebutuhan pengguna. Nah, jadi kalau penggunanya butuh apa, maka sistem informasi akan menyesuaikan dengan kebutuhan dari penggunanya. Oke, saya harap membantu. Pertanyaan kedua, Prof. Mengapa dari M. Ridwan Trisaputra, mengapa sistem informasi begitu penting dalam menjalankan dan mengelola bisnis saat ini? Why is information system is so important to support business?
Okay, boleh imagine tak kita punya life without information system?
Okay.
Kita kena ingat information system untuk menguruskan data. Kenapa penting? Sebab hari-hari kita banyak data. The data tu maksud dia apa? The data hari-hari. Kita beli barang pun kita ada data, berapa jumlah bayaran untuk produk kita beli. Kita beli sayur, berapa harga sayur. Itu semua data. So, macam mana kita nak menguruskan data secara efisien? Macam mana kita nak simpan data tersebut, maka kita kena ada information system. Itu kepentingan dia untuk manage kita punya data. Ada
Okay, sorry. Jadi sistem informasi itu penting untuk mengelola data dalam bisnisnya ya, gitu ya, Prof ya. Oke. Pertanyaan selanjutnya dari M. Lutfi Septorio. Jadi maaf Prof, saya sedikit cepat karena banyak sekali pertanyaannya.
Ya, pertanyaannya ada.
Apakah sistem informasi akan berpengaruh pada budaya belanja manusia? Jadi maksudnya sistem informasi.
Actually, it goes back to it goes back to your individual. Kalau dari dulu pun kita memang suka berbelanja, kita akan suka berbelanja. So sekarang kita terpulang kepada kita macam mana. Semua benda-benda tu semua ada di depan mata kita. Kadang-kadang kedai pun di depan mata. Okay, keluar je ada shopping mall. So adakah you nak beli bergantung kepada you punya keperluan. So bukan sebab information system dah menyebabkan you spend more. You spend more. Okay, mungkin kita berbelanja lebih sebab kita ada online shopping. Okay, online banking, senang klik button, duit transfer, boleh beli barang cepat. So semua tu kena pandai control, it's up to individual sendiri. Mungkin masyarakat, mungkin pihak-pihak tertentu kena create awareness, kesedaran untuk menguruskan keuangan.
Yeah.
Okay, dengan challenges from information system.
Yeah, jadi tergantung ke individunya ya Prof ya. Karena sebagian
setiap hari mau beli handbag, setiap hari mau beli handbag online, memanglah akan miskin.
Oke, baik. Pertanyaan selanjutnya Prof dari Muhammad Iqbal Setiantah. Ini pakai bahasa Malaysia atau gimana nih? Mana implement saat ini berkenaan sistem maklumat dalam hal ehwal bisnis yang ada di Malaysia dan seberapa perhatian kerajaan dalam hal berkenaan? Mungkin Prof sudah mengerti pertanyaannya.
Macam mana implement saat ini dengan sistem maklumat? Okay, in business okay. Malaysia, okay, in business Malaysia, we use a lot of e-business. Okay, Grab is very popular in Malaysia, and in university all mostly computerized system, and we have big grocery stores like Tesco. So we have self checkout. You know self checkout? Kalau kita pergi ke kedai, kita ada orang yang tolong kira duit, kita bayar. Sekarang kita sendiri yang kira barang kita, kita sendiri bayar. Itu sudah ada di Malaysia, dekat Tesco. And then sekarang kita bayar cashless. E-wallet, touch and go e-wallet. You pergi kedai aja, you just, as long as you have money in your mobile phone, you just scan the code, they have that application, you can just pay straight away. Okay, so it goes back to if you do not know how to manage, of course you will spend more because you just touch the button. You don't use physical money.
Okay. Next question, Prof. From Ragil Tri Wahyudi. It's topik penelitian mengenai penerapan IS di bisnis yang sedang tren, terutama di Malaysia. Jadi bertanya mengenai topik penelitian. On research, IS.
Research in Malaysia sekarang kita blockchain dengan Internet of Things. Internet of Things is now is the current in Malaysia. In Uniten, okay, we are doing research in Internet of Things. We are doing research in artificial intelligence, also blockchain. Blockchain is very new. So probably even student in UIN also wants to explore blockchain technology. Okay, so that means saya pernah bagi talk pasal blockchain dekat Universiti Islam di Malaysia mengenai blockchain. Macam mana blockchain, kita tak guna third party dah untuk bayar. Semua transaction is direct. That is blockchain. CJ nanti degree student also through digital certificates. Digital degree. Itu guna blockchain.
So we are into that the... now. Okay, how about the research about implementation on IS? For example, like TAM
yes.
model?
Yes, I am the one who is, that is my research. I have, my research is basically on the adoption of information system. Okay, on the Dillon and McLean, on TAM, on TRAM, on UTAW. So that is my research. So all my PhD student now, six PhD student doing adoption of studies.
I think Prof, sorry for this stuff, Bu Mala. Yeah. I think Prof Asikin is one of the potential supervisor for you. And then Prof, I hope you can give us a discount, maybe free tuition fee, something like that. So you, it can be help Bu Mala to continue her PhD. Inshallah.
Okay.
You can apply scholarship. Yeah. You can apply for scholarship. I show just now.
Yes, Bu Mala is very good. One of the best lecturer in sistem informasi, Prof.
Oh, I know, you're kidding.
You are welcome. Yeah. And then I can provide talk about how to write research proposal.
Oh, really good.
How to write research review, because I have conducted workshops in Unit 10, how to face Viva, how to do literature review, how to conduct, how to write research proposal. I have been helping students at Unit 10.
Yes, actually, that's one of my limitations, Prof, on writing the research proposal for PhD.
I came to AGM to give talk about how to write a paper. Oh. So in the end, I collaborate with one of the lecturers in UAGM in the conference. So we wrote together, and she managed to write. We got best paper award.
Oh.
Alhamdulillah.
The lecturer Ibu Louis from UAGM.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, we move on, yes, Prof, to the questions. Yeah. From Alfarabi, apakah sistem informasi di bidang bisnis yang sekarang sudah banyak berkembang seperti Shopee, OnLapak, sudah sesuai dalam memenuhi kebutuhan customer? Dan apa harapan Ibu untuk perkembangan sistem informasi di bidang bisnis di masa yang akan datang? Oke. Okay. You get the question?
Shopee is now popular. In future, you have to think for the next 10 years, for the next 5 years. I think Shopee will be around for the next 5 years. But probably in the next 10 years, there will be another business platform. Sekarang ni Food Panda. I'm not sure Palembang ada Food Panda. Ada Food Panda in Palembang?
Ada, Bro.
Foodpanda
in Malaysia, di mana actually restoran guna application system untuk jual dia punya makanan.
Oh, we use.
So GoFood. Kalau saya
GoFood, Prof.
Yes.
GoFood or GrabFood in Palembang.
Dulu Foodpanda tak ada, kita ada Grab. The first is Grab. Yeah. Then after Grab, we have Foodpanda. That means kalau saya malas masak, saya order saja, then makanan akan sampai depan rumah. That is very easy nowadays. Okay, that is Foodpanda. So in future, probably I want to see how actually all those things that we cannot access now. Katalah macam sekarang pasar kita ada jual chicken. Mungkin kita boleh order online sekarang, tetapi tak popular sangat. Mungkin masa hadapan pasar jadi pasar bergerak, mobile pasar. Kita nak beli daging, kita nak beli ayam secara mobile. That one is not popular yet. But other than that, probably is new all this fingerprint lah. Instead of because of the security, probably now in future we use a lot of fingerprint. Kita ada smart home. Smart home that means duduk kat rumah pun, sebelum sampai rumah kita dah bagi notice through mobile apps untuk pressure cooker ataupun rice cooker masak nasi. So now in Malaysia, smart home is what you call, kita dalam promosi of smart home, tetapi tak popular sebab, bukan tak popular, tak popular lagi sebab smart home untuk orang-orang kaya yang ada duit.
Yeah. We cannot afford it because
mana orang-orang kampung untuk jadi smart city, smart home. They have to be smart. What does it mean by smart city? Kita kena juga cater, accommodate untuk orang-orang yang di kampung. Sekarang smart home untuk orang-orang di city saja. Kalau saya ada smart door tu guna fingerprint. Saya baru install smart door dekat rumah. Harga dia RM1,600. It's very expensive, right? So for the next 10 years, kalau kita nak ada smart home, mungkin smart door jadi RM500. Orang dah boleh mampu. Sekarang very expensive, RM1,000 sebab dia guna fingerprint. Nak masuk rumah, tekan je guna jari, pintu buka. Saya guna itu di rumah sekarang.
Okay, Prof. Nah, next question dari Hibzir Ridho. Pertanyaannya, dengan adanya COVID-19 menjadi keberkahan atau malah menjadi malapetaka terhadap perkembangan teknologi di Malaysia?
Okay, seperti yang saya cakap tadi kan, COVID-19 kita nampak sebagai musibah, sebagai bala kepada kita, dan juga kita perlu muhasabah diri. Okay, muhasabah diri, peringatan kepada Allah SWT, mungkin kita ada banyak maksiat kat dunia ini sebab kerosakan di muka bumi ini dari tangan kita sendiri. Tetapi kita jangan lupa Allah itu Maha Pengasih dan Penyayang, di mana dalam keadaan COVID, Allah bagi manusia untuk berfikir, untuk develop information system. Sebab tu Allah jadikan manusia sebagai khalifah. Okay, khalifah di muka bumi ini, di mana kita mampu berfikir, kita menggunakan kepakaran otak yang diberi oleh Allah untuk membina sesuatu untuk kebaikan. So bila adanya COVID, Allah bagi kita kepakaran untuk build information system untuk membantu situasi-situasi yang berhadapan dengan COVID. For example, maklumat melalui website. Okay, kita boleh buat data analytics mengenai pesakit-pesakit COVID. Kita boleh guna drone untuk keep track pesakit-pesakit, location of pesakit supaya kita can prevent. Itu kalau kita imagine semasa dulu COVID datang tanpa information system, semua orang akan depress duduk dalam rumah. Nak beli makanan tak boleh, nak makan tak boleh sebab tak ada food panda, tak ada grab and so on. So kita boleh kena ada dekat diri kita positive thinking, bersangka baik kepada Allah ni. Di mana bila Allah bagi sesuatu, dia sungguhnya akan bagi sesuatu yang lebih baik pada kita. Walaupun dia bagi COVID, kita tetap boleh hidup aman damai. Kita tak ada perang kalau compare dengan negara-negara lain yang sentiasa dalam peperangan. Okay.
Pertanyaan selanjutnya dari Feby, apa saja lambat sistem informasi dalam mengimplementasikan ke suatu bisnis?
Oh, diverse, factors. Okay. Factors to must have support if management. Because if you remember, I put the challenges there in order to implement, you need funds. So where do you get the funds from? From the top management to approve the funds. Okay. You have a collaboration with industry. Syarikat-syarikat komputer boleh membantu untuk develop information system collaboration. Okay. So pensyarah boleh bekerjasama dengan para-para industri.
Oke, okay, jadi maksudnya Prof. Nur Askin ialah kita harus mendapat dukungan dari manajemen tingkat atas. But Feby Saputra is asking about the limitation information system, Prof.
Implementation system. Ada barriers. Yes. Bila kita nak develop information system, okay, kita kena ada expertise. Kita kena ada people who are expert. So you have to identify the organization sama ada you nak develop sendiri information system menggunakan kepakaran di dalam you punya organization ataupun you nak outsource. Okay, bayar kepada orang luar untuk develop information system for you. So kita kena analyze adakah kebaikan develop dalam atau kebaikan develop kat luar. Kalau nak di dalam buat sendiri information system, do you have kepakaran? Ada kepakaran tak? Kita ada system analyst cukup, kita ada programmers yang pandai dalam sesuatu sistem untuk develop. Itu kita punya limitation.
Okay. Jadi yang faktor penghambatnya adalah uang atau dana dan keahlian orang yang ahli di bidang sistem informasinya. Jadi kalau kita punya orang yang ahli, itu akan memudahkan kita dalam mengembangkan sistem informasi, terutama didukung dengan biaya ya Prof ya. Oke, baik, pertanyaan selanjutnya dari Torik Amrillah. Jadi selain dampak positif, bagaimana dampak negatif kemajuan information system di dunia kerja di masa yang akan datang bagi manusia?
Okey, semasa saya belajar dulu, masa zaman saya dah dengar kata, okey, IT no longer use. Dia akan replace manusia. So manusia ni tak ada pekerjaan lah yang orang IT ni. Tapi sekarang saya tengok lebih lagi ramai demand. Tadi saya dah tunjukkan berapa ramai demand untuk IT sebab apa? Kita dah ada Internet of Things, tapi Internet of Things memerlukan kepakaran. Internet of Things tak akan terjadi tanpa ada manusia yang yang implement Internet of Things. Sistem akan tanpa manusia untuk implement. So this is to provide opportunities, lebih peluang pekerjaan kepada IT, IT people. Okay, bukan nak ada IT mengurangkan pekerjaan untuk manusia, tak. Lebihnya sebab kita, contoh, kalau kita security komputer, kita ada orang untuk tengok antivirus and so on, okay. Tetapi sekarang kita ada security system all over the world. Kita boleh access from other parts of the world. Kita ada cloud. So kita lebih perlukan ramai orang yang bekerja dalam bidang IT yang specialize dalam cyber security, dalam security system bahagian cloud, dalam security system untuk Internet of Things. Semua ini memerlukan kepakaran. Jadi pekerjaan untuk IT lebih bertambah dengan lebih advance sesuatu IT itu.
Jadi maksudnya dengan teknologi justru pekerjaan manusia akan makin bertambah, makin banyak peluang kerja. Ya, jadi dia teknologi tidak akan menghambat pekerjaan manusia, justru makin bertambah sesuai yang dijelasin sama Prof ya terakhir-terakhir. Oke. Okay.
Mungkin orang argue ya, mungkin orang argue kata, "Oh, kita sekarang dah ada robot menggantikan manusia." Tak. Robot itu ada limitationnya. Robot tak boleh berfikir. So kalau aeroplane, takkan kita nak suruh robot drive aeroplane, kita mau pilot, betul. Untuk IT also, nak check virus, okay, administrator network down, kita bukan robot, orang akan report kepada manusia. And then manusia, then kita masih memerlukan pekerja-pekerja IT untuk solve IT problems. Robot is very limited.
Jadi teknologi itu masih juga digerakkan oleh manusia ya. Pertanyaan selanjutnya, Prof, dari Bahri. Dari Bahri, jika sistem informasi semakin banyak mendukung bisnis dan menghadirkan berbagai platform baru yang semakin canggih, organisasi bisnis itu sendiri, okay, agar tetap bisa saing. So the challenge in business.
Okay. The challenge business, okay, if you think that, okay, like information systems, semua kedai ada same system, okay, semua efficient. So, what you have to do, you have to find niche products. Kalau satu, contoh, kalau dekat Palembang contohnya, dekat Palembang ada itu, online store, what do you call, you purchase online, they deliver food to your house. Macam grocery store.
We use GoFood or GrabFood. GoFood.
Okay. Ada self-checkout. Tak perlukan orang untuk cashier. You sendiri
we have that.
Okay, you have that. And then in future, mungkin kita tambah ada fingerprint ke RFID. Semua tu try to be niche. Try to be distinct from other people. Kita kena be creative, innovative. Macam mana orang lain dah sama, ada information macam kita. Macam mana kita nak gunakan teknologi yang lebih advance untuk membantu kita punya business. Lebih unik. It's called niche. N-I-C-H-E. Niche. Very different from others.
Okay, jadi kalau setiap bisnis itu menggunakan IT, tapi setiap bisnis itu harus mempunyai keunikan sendiri supaya bisa bersaing antar bisnis yang menggunakan teknologi. Jadi punya ciri khas atau punya
macam
teknologi yang lebih
daripada bisnis-bisnis. Macam kita ada jual pempek. Okay, semua orang mau jual pempek. Macam mana kita nak pempek kita berdaya. Kita guna information system, kalau orang tu tak guna yang ni, kita fikir macam mana kita guna information technology yang boleh melariskan kita punya pempek. First of course, recipe has to be nice, good food. But beside that, how do you think information system can help you to improve business pempek compared to other people?
Thank you, Prof. And next question is, do you have a title for information system paper?
Okay, just now how I'll show you how to use Google, right?
Information system paper.
Google?
Yeah.
Okay, students must know how to use Google very well. Because Google, you can get any paper. So what you have to do, you use Scholar Google. S-C-H-O-L-A-R, Scholar Google. So in that Scholar Google, you can have... Google Scholar, you can have all the papers there. So you can find the topics for information system there. Okay. So for your final year project, you can think, you read first what other people have done. You just improve a little bit. Then become your project.
Nah, jadi kita bisa menggunakan Google Scholar ya, Wahyu Oktiawan. Oke, pertanyaan selanjutnya dari Fahrul Adib. Bagaimana cara kita mengetahui bahwa bisnis yang kita lakukan dapat berkembang dengan baik atau tidak?
Oh, and then you use data analytics. Analyze. You kena guna, that is to use information system. Contohnya macam kalau satu syarikat itu ada banyak branches. So kita tengok, kita guna data mining. Okay, branches ni dekat area ni, kita tengok kasut dia tak berapa profitable. Okay, so how do you want to make it profitable? And then kita use data mining. Kita get the knowledge why kawasan ni lebih profitable and why kawasan ni making losses, rugi. So kita guna data analytics ataupun data mining untuk mine the data. Kita nak cari kenapa, soalan dia why. Kalau dulu data is just to give what? What is, how many shoes do we have? Now kita nak tanya kenapa tak ada profit. Then kita guna advanced information system, data mining.
Okay. Jadi kita menggunakan data analitik ya, salah satunya adalah dengan menggunakan data mining. Jadi ada peramalan di sana gitu ya. Selanjutnya pertanyaan dari Jainur Rohman. Bagaimana solusi Ibu tentang pembuatan sebuah sistem tanpa memangkas pekerjaan atau penghasilan orang lain? So, what do you think about when we make a information system but we do not cut people, what do you call, yeah, people job?
How does information system cut other people's job? Information system, we don't cut other people's job. Information system is for our organization to improve our business processes.
Maybe
we can give more jobs to people.
Yeah, maybe in some kind some business we can cut, misal in fabric, prof, yeah, in industry we can cut our employee to install something, but we use robot to install it.
It was like this. Okay, kalau kita ada information system, contohnya cleaner ya. Kita ada cleaners. Okay. Cleaners ni, sekarang kita tak nak cleaners, kita dah ada robot. Kita tak perlukan cleaners. Maknanya kita dah cuba memangkas, dia kata memangkas pekerjaan cleaners ya. Kita jangan memangkas pekerjaan cleaner. Kita ambil kerja cleaner, orang yang kerja cleaner, kita improve dia kerja di bahagian pentadbiran yang lain.
Akan dia ke tempat pindahkan, yang lain ya.
Jadi ilmu dia akan bertambah. Kita hantar dia training untuk bahagian lain yang memerlukan manusia. So kalau bahagian cleaner, kita biar robot yang buat. Takkan selama-lamanya cleaner jadi cleaner kan? Kita let IT take over robot. And then cleaner ni kita improve dia supaya dia punya ekonomi lebih maju dengan pekerjaan yang lebih baik.
Okay.
Harap paham.
Baik, terima kasih Prof. Selanjutnya, ya. Selanjutnya Jody Setiawan. Jadi ada beberapa bulan lalu Raja Malaysia Pertuan Agong Sultan Abdullah. Iya. Apakah di Malaysia ada terobosan sistem informasi untuk pemilu, Prof?
Oh, ini bukan. Ini hanyalah gosip-gosip.
Oke.
Okay.
Okay, it's a
gossip. Rumas-rumas. Jadi salah satu disadvantage IT ni adalah terlalu cepat rumus berkembang. Okay. Sebab tu kita sebagai orang Islam, kita kena adapt, bila ethics kita kena adapt untuk menggunakan IT. Bila kita dapat satu message, kita check dulu sahih atau tak. Is that authentic message? If yes, kita forward. Kalau kita forward benda yang kita tak tahu, source dari mana, tak betul, itu fitnah. Dosa sebab kita forward. Kalau seorang dapat, 1,000 dapat, kita kena tanggung 1,000. Dosa sebab disebabkan kita forward benda yang tak betul. Sebab tu sebagai orang Islam, kita ada hadis sahih, kita ada rujuk Al-Quran. Sebab apa rujukan? Sebab benda tu ada sahih. Sama juga bila belajar, kita rujuk pada tempat yang sahih. Dapat ilmu, dapat satu berita tiap-tiap hari, kita make sure itu benda adalah sahih.
Okay, thank you Prof. It's just a gossip, ya. Yeah? So, we don't need to debate it. Okay, next question is from Faisal Akbar. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Prof, my name is Faisal Akbar. I am a student from the Information System Study Program at UI Negeri Palembang. Please, permission to ask, what kind of technology is applied at Uniten? How is the implementation related to the campus performance? And what potential impacts arise from the application of this information technology to Uniten? Okay.
What kind of technology? Okay, technology, there are many. There are many technology, itu kan talking about information system, yeah, we have all, everything is online, application online, registration online. So for every individual faculty also we have our intranet. Okay, when we have meeting online nowadays, so now we just access online documents, no more we print the papers, and printers, we have shared printers. Not every individual has printer. We can have shared printers. Okay, so, all the system are computerized. And then attendance student, we use QR code. Macam mana attendance student di UIN? Raden Fatah. We use QR code to take attendance. The code.
I think they did not use QR code prop.
Oh, maybe okay. Yes.
Yeah. So, they have to. They use e-learning.
Okay. Okay. In Uniten, okay. Before this, we have QR code. So if you attend in the class, the lecturer will open that QR code. The student just scan through their smartphone. Hmm. And we are in the midst of having smart university. So we are into being a smart university. So that means we have a transportation system that is what you call everything is through we want to embed in Internet of Things macam Grab. Kita ada Grab dalam university campus. So we want to become smart university. Okay. So but still at early stage. Sekarang, that is one of the technology that is current in Uniten, Smart University.
Okay, next we have Fitri Jumaila, who raised hand. Maybe you want to ask questions. Okay, go ahead, Fitri.
Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, Prof. My name is Fitri Salva Jumaila. I want to ask about PhD program. I'm really excited about PhD program in the last slide. How about the regulation for PhD program in Uniten? And criteria for PhD student? And how about the fee? And a fee for a PhD program and a fee for living? In there.
Cost of living.
Yeah, cost of living.
And the last about criteria like a proposal for dissertation. How about that?
Okay. Okay, PhD program, we have PhD in ICT. Okay, the student can apply online. We have online application. You can go to www.uniten.edu.my. That is Uniten website. And you can apply for postgraduate program. Okay, so they will ask you to enter your user ID register as usual lah. And the fees is per semester roughly. I can't remember because I don't remember much. But the fees we can check later. You can also check the fees to the website. It's around 5,000 per semester. Okay, for PhD, 5,000 per semester ringgit. And then we have the scholarship is to help. Not full scholarship, but to help pay the tuition fees. You can see now 15,000, 12,000, just like that to help the tuition fees. And in terms of proposal, yes, when you want to apply, you need to come up with a proposal because you want to match you with the supervisor. Okay, you see the topic and who is the right supervisor for you. Because PhD, the most important is your supervisor. Okay, you will be with him or her for 3 to 4 years. Okay, so you must have a good relationship with the supervisor and you must have a mutual understanding. So that is very important. And then after that, you think of the topic, the area that you want to focus on. Sometimes what you want, so the topic is not necessarily permanent. Sometimes you think of that topic, but later on when you go to, you meet the supervisor, probably supervisor asks you to narrow down. So it could be different. Okay, and the other thing, you have proposal defense. Once you register, you are accepted, you are matched, so you will start your journey as PhD, so doing literature review, so your proposal defense will start within 1 year.
Okay. How about the English requirement, Prof? So be they need
IELTS,
IELTS or TOEFL?
IELTS or TOEFL. Untuk IELTS, untuk IT is 5.5.
Okay.
Yes. TOEFL, I think 550.
So it's like less than 5.5, it's about 500. It's like, yeah.
550.
Do, I mean that, do you also accept what we call that ITP TOEFL? Institutional TOEFL, I think. Something like that, but this is international.
Okay, no problem.
So okay. For the IELTS 5.5, yeah.
Then English is our medium of instruction. Everything is in English.
Okay.
Definitely, you can speak Malay with your supervisor because it's Malay, but the writing is in English.
Yeah. So sorry, Prof. I also because this is also for my friends there. What we call that? So, I mean that when they, what we call that, when they are become your students, so is there any, what we call that, coursework class they have to follow, or in Unitel is on, in Unitel, everything is a core, what we call that, full research.
Not, full research, except you need to take a research methodology class. That's all.
Oh, I see.
Okay. Research methodology class is only to whether you fail or pass, just to make sure that you understand the research methodology. Mm-hmm. This is very critical for your PhD. So the rest is full research.
Full research.
Full research.
And then they got facilities for work if they want to come to Malaysia.
Yeah.
Or yeah, they got what we call that, like desktop, yes. Something like that.
Yeah. Once a while, if you are allowed to come to visit Malaysia, you can come. You can have a research room with other postgraduate.
That's the most important one.
With other postgraduate students, but we don't provide computers. You have to use your own computers.
Oh, okay. Thank you, Prof. Maybe. Some of my colleagues will be ask you another question then.
Okay.
Thank you, Prof. Yeah.
Thank you, Prof. Maybe we can talk about it more next time. But we have another question. Farhan Filial. Okay. silakan Farhan di unmute.
Ya, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Halo, Mrs. Asikin, salam serumpun.
Ya,
between the so the interaction between information technology most affected by meditation factor like society, culture, structure, politics, and your chance how to get there. How to or what organization can optimize the information system with technology that we use right now? How can we optimize the organization of information system with the technology we use right now?
So it goes back to what you want at the end. Objective is very important. What is your goal? If first you identify the objective first, then from the objective only you can optimize your IT. Okay, so you need the expert there to analyze the situation first. So in your organization, first you have to do the SWOT analysis. What is the strength of your government or your organization? So what is the limitation? So what is the threat there? So the threat of your... business come from where? External or your competitor, then you can use your information system to beat your competitor through information system, through technology. So you have to understand the environment first. So what actually do competitors, how do competitors use their information system? So how do you want to be advanced more than that competitor so that we can optimize our IT technology for our organization? Okay, so you have to analyze first. You cannot simply purchase IT just because we don't have IT. Sometimes you can, sometimes people like, okay, because of that company has IT, I want to have IT. It doesn't work that way. So what is important first, you must understand the objective. Then you must have the strategy. Okay, what actually you want to implement. And you have to look at your business processes. What are your business processes now? What are the weaknesses of the current business processes? Probably the current weakness, because the business processes now that you have is weak, that cause you to be left behind from other competitors. So you improve your business processes. If your processes normally take 1 week, other competitors only take 1 day. So you have to make sure IT can improve your processes to be less than 1 day. If that company take 1 day, you can take about half a day. So that is how you compete, you optimize.
I think. I got, so I need to analyze first and then improve my process of business.
Yes, of course, you have to analyze the weakness first, the limitation first. Oh. What are the threats, what are the opportunities? So you look at, and then once you do the analysis, you have to provide the strategy. Strategy could be from the type of information system you want to have, who are the people involved. So all this must come before you implement. So that to avoid waste of money.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mrs.
Yeah, you're
okay, I can see that's a lot of questions still remaining, Prof, but we have a limitation of time. So maybe we can finish Imam. We have kami punya kenang-kenangan untuk Prof Nur Asikin sebagai tanda terima kasih untuk acara ini.
Oh, thank you very much.
Ya, pempeknya menyusul ya, Prof. Maybe next time if COVID-19 is over, you can come to Uyan Aden Patah, Palembang.
Yeah, yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you. Terima kasih, Prof, atas sharing knowledge-nya. Terima kasih.
Yeah. Terima kasih sama-sama dan minta maaf kalau ada kekurangan dari pihak saya.
Oke, okay, saya minta maaf juga sama peserta yang lain yang punya banyak pertanyaan ke Prof. Nur Asikin ya, tapi karena waktu kita yang terbatas, jadi semua pertanyaan tidak bisa tertampung. Oke, okay, terima kasih untuk Prof. Nur Asikin. Materi Prof. bisa di-share karena kami belum dapat dari Prof. materinya.
Ibu Malak, mohon maaf Bu, ini Prof Ashikin, nanti if it is possible for us the next few months maybe or next year, few months already next year actually, it is possible for us to have MOU later on inshallah with Unitan, that's between a system information system or science tech faculty. Yes.
I have asked already those in charge of MOU, so you can suggest first what kind of MOU that you want to have. Mm-hmm. We don't have any problem with MOU, no problem at all. Okay. Yeah, then we can work on the collaboration part. Okay, research collaboration.
Yes.
Either you come here or we go there as invited like a speaker. Okay. And co-supervise.
That's the most important one.
Co-supervision. Because let's say Puan Rosmala, Ibu Rosmala, kalau nak buat PhD mungkin saya sebagai supervisor di Unitan contoh ya, dan co-supervisor mungkin di Palembang.
Boleh macam tu ya, Prof. Ya,
tapi kena ada PhD ya. Minimum supervisor kena ada PhD.
Yeah.
Mungkin apa ni, Darussalam, Bapak Darussalam habiskan cepat PhD jadi supervisor.
Iya, Darussalam.
Insyaallah, Prof. Ya, nanti ini Prof, nanti kita kita mesti ada Ibu Penny, mungkin Ibu Penny nak Ibu Penny mau bicara sesuatu, nanti kita kita berharap ini tidak hanya satu kali ini, tapi kita akan punya program-program yang lain yang akan melibatkan Prof Ashikin sebagai our member, our team, maybe insyaallah we will have Bu Penny punya planning untuk buat conference, international conference, and maybe Prof Ashikin will be one of the keynote speaker insyaallah later on maybe, but it will be good after this pandemic.
Yeah. Yes.
Insyaallah. Ya, makasih Bu Mala atas waktunya. Maaf Bu ya mengganggu.
Mohonlah membantu sekali. Oke, terima kasih ya Prof. Jadi sebelum pisah, sebelum berfoto, sebelum dan lain-lain sebagainya, ada pantun sedikit lagi. Di rumah ada jendela. Jendela berjumlah 5. Walau kita tak bersua, semoga materi bisa diterima. Nice-nya. Kasih foto-foto ya, Prof. Silakan. Pantun.
Bapak Ibu, mohon mengaktifkan videonya yang akan dipandu oleh Ibu Fathia. Kami persilakan Ibu Fathia.
Saya mohon Bapak Ibu untuk mengaktifkan videonya.
Kami mohon kepada Bapak dan Ibu untuk mengaktifkan video karena sesaat akan kita dokumentasikan.
Hitung 1, 2, 3.
Boleh Bu Fathia dipandu 1, 2, 3. Screen keberapa sekarang?
Lanjut aja, Pak.
Iya, bisa dilanjutkan Bu Fathia, screen pertama. Oke. Screen yang kedua sekarang. Udah siap, Bu Fat? Yang kedua. Ya, ya, boleh dilanjutkan Bu Fat, screen yang kedua. Baik, sekarang screen yang ketiga. Selanjutnya, screen yang keempat. Dan terakhir, screen yang kelima. Oke, baik. Kami ucapkan terima kasih kepada Bu Fathia dan juga sekali lagi kami ucapkan terima kasih kepada narasumber utama kita, Ibu Associate Professor Tes Dr. Nur Asikin Ali. Senang sekali sudah mendapatkan ilmu dari Ibu dan juga Bu Mala sebagai moderator pada hari ini. Tidak salah kalau saya coba menutup dengan sebuah pantun juga, Bu. Musim hujan banyak buah-buahan, tak berbeda dengan musim kemarau. Terima kasih dan salam tak terlupakan kehadiran Bapak Ibu, semoga sehat selalu. Kami yang bertugas, panitia, mengucapkan terima kasih dan mohon maaf atas segala salah dan khilaf kepada Allah Subhanahu wa taala, ampunan yang kita harapkan, dan sampai berjumpa pada acara yang lainnya. Mari sama-sama kita tutup dengan membacakan doa kifaratul majelis. Subhanallah bihamdi, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, asyhadu alla ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih
semua ya. Terima kasih Bu Prof.
Materi yang disajikan tadi.
Mohon maaf untuk materinya Bu Nur Asikin, bagaimana?
Materi.
Bisa ya. Bisa di-share ke Ibu Rusmala Santi.
Oh, nanti saya nanti saya mintakan ke Prof Asikin, nanti biar Prof Asikin kirim ke WA saya dan saya akan kirim ke Prof Ibu Mala atau Bu Feni.
Ya, baik, terima kasih Pak Darus. Sehat selalu Pak Darus. Salam.
Sama-sama.
Ayo Bu.
Jadi kalau salam balik baru gantian.
Oh gitu yo.
Terima kasih.
Sudah selesai?
Tadi berdoa saya pun mantap melawan kamu mengharumkan dunia pendidikan.
Amin.